jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Now, there you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. You know, peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly with a baseball bat. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly with a baseball bat. Now, where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Now, there you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Now, peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly.
This is John Fitzgerald Kennedy. You're now listening to the very first PB&Gains podcast.
I am Ben McMillan. I run the nutrition side of things here, lifestyle. Sitting down here with David Fennell and Derek Castillo. I'll let them talk here in a second. I'll let them introduce themselves. So, David, why don't you tell us a little bit more about you?
Again, so my name is David Fennell. I'm here all about the peanut butter and gains. So gains for everyone is a little different, and that's kind of what our thing is. Even gains can mean losing stuff as well, like losing weight or gaining muscle, gaining strength. Again, you could be getting off medications. That's a gain as well, gain in your health, gain in sleep. So really, gains is not just about the weight and the numbers, and that's kind of our thing is we want to get away from the number counting, calorie counting, number crunching. It's just too much time now. So actually, you gain more time back by actually cutting some of these unnecessary steps out, and that's what we're about is, you know, a healthy lifestyle and just trying to cut stuff out and make it more efficient, enjoy life, and make some gains that way.
What's up, guys? This is Derek. Yeah, like David was saying, gains can definitely mean a different definition for every one of us. It just depends on how you want to define it, whatever makes you feel better every day. Wake up, get a good night's sleep, eat healthy, get a good workout, whatever workout you want to do makes you feel better throughout the day, get you going. And that's just basically how we came up with the names. Just getting better every day and feel like we're gaining something from it.
So you talked about what gets you going. We'll address that first off. What gets me going is a good bicep crunch, a bicep curl. That sounds very professional, I know. Yeah, gains, pretty big deal. I'm Ben, like I said, lifestyle, run that here, done that for at least a year. And so I said, our whole mission is to get you on the right foot and make sure you're moving towards something beneficial and gaining something for yourself, whether that be knowledge or newfound self-confidence. Whatever it is, we want to have fun with it along the way. So that is your definition of gain. So in the future, when you tell somebody that you listen to PB&Gains and they say, what the hell is that? You can explain it all to them. Then, or just refer them over to episode one of PB&Gains, which would be awesome as well. So what can you expect from this podcast? We don't really know. It's kind of a mystery. Anybody want to chime in on any of that? Feel free. But I'm saying, like, it's what do you expect is good knowledge. We're going to bring in different people. I mean, we have a pretty good crew lined up. Different farmers talking about what a family farm is these days versus what it used to be. Getting kettlebell workouts in. New technology, you know, how that can benefit you with sleep. I mean, a number of things. It's all coming. And any way we can help you out, we're going to put it here on this podcast. We've been fortunate enough to meet some pretty cool, interesting people in this field, so we're going to just bring them to you and connect you to these experts. That way you can improve and make your gains.
So gains also, I mean, we can talk about mobility. We're going to try to meet up with some doctors, some physical therapists, chiropractors, anything that's in kind of the mobility world or movement, and make sure we can find out some ways to get gains there as well. But yeah, getting a lineup of different people coming in and living a healthy lifestyle, and that's what it's all about in making gains there.
Yeah, for real. Derek, you seem to have a lot to say on this topic.
I think we're saying gains too much.
He's a man of many words, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to say gains because it's branding, so guess what? Deal with that now. We'll cut it back.
It's going to be cut into your mind.
Yeah, branded. You'll wake up every morning, and the first thing that will pop up in your head will be gains.
What gains can I make today?
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to have it tattooed on my chest after this show. Or David pointed to his butt. You guys can't see that. We're working on the film version of this. Steven Spielberg is going to record it. So yeah, that's what to expect. Mobility, farming, anything that is fitness related, even stuff that's not, because it's interesting. We talked about the pagan influence on Christmas today. So who knows? There could be a whole show on that. We don't know. It's edutainment is the word I like to use. And so that's the direction. And we're really trying to make this something cool. So any feedback you guys have, any ideas you have, something that would drive you to get better, shoot it our way. I'll have some stuff for contact information, show notes, all that good stuff. But we're going to take a quick break to make sure that our stuff is actually recording, because that would be terrible. Talked about avenuefit.com and mentioned to go check it out. So Avenue Fit, who the heck is that? Why do you care? Why should you care? Well, that's who employs us, so that's why we care. But our whole message was to kind of disrupt fitness and really make a big change and change how people see health and wellness. And it's not about, you know, biceps, unfortunately, for some people, or crunches and all that. It's more about getting that self-confidence and gaining something for yourself. And I know that it takes a different path for each of us, and we try and be as unique as we possibly can with it all. So Avenue is built up into something differently. We used to be Westview Fitness, and since we made that change, and our branding has changed dramatically. So it's a kind of a new beginning for us. And so that's kind of our next, hopefully, transition into what we're going to talk about. And really beginning what it is to be in, you know, health and wellness. So most people, they want to do all this crazy, crazy stuff. They don't start in the simple, basic steps. So we want to hit on those. What are those few basic things you need to do if you are starting a new program or just getting into moving better, feeling better, whatever it is? So I'll throw that out to the group here. Like, if you had to give one thing, just one tip about, you know, someone beginning a new program, what would it be?
For me, it'd be like just moving. Like, honestly, people are asking, like, man, what can I do on the weekends? Like, do I want to do sprints or give me a workout to do? I'm like, just get up and move. Most of my clients have kids, and really, it's like, man, the kids are always moving. Move with your kids. Get out there, throw a ball around. You know, you can set up cones. Some of them are always, you know, training for a sport or baseball, but really, just get out, play. A lot of times, people just forget how to play. Most play involves moving. Really, that's the most basic, simple step that I could recommend anyone doing. And, you know, when you play, you have fun, and no one can argue with that.
No, I think with the play thing is huge, because as an adult, how many of you guys go out and just play? Like, just go to somewhere without having some scripted 3 sets of 10 rep workouts. And I know that can be hard to deal with at times, but just going out and just doing something just to say you did something. I mean, our bodies were programmed as basically animals to move. It is like food for ourselves, so you should be able to do that and have fun. It should be fun. Otherwise, what is the point? I don't know. That's me. What do you think?
I mean, for me, the main thing is getting your proper sleep, just sleeping more, and just making sure you're getting at least 7-8 hours of sleep each night. That way your body will feel, you know, the way it's supposed to be the next day, for whether it's work, working out, whatever activity you're doing throughout the day. But that's probably the one basic tip that I would give people, just getting your sleep every night.
It's pretty basic, yeah. We need our sleep. Dogs get their sleep.
Yeah. You watch your dog laying on the ground, or babies. If you watch a baby, that's what they do most of the time, is sleep, cry, and poop.
That's how they get their gains.
That's gains. Yeah, that's how they get to be adults.
Their bodies are growing so much, and they just need so much sleep.
Yeah, and there's this whole like idea out there that you're a hero if you don't get sleep, which is pretty ridiculous. You know, it's a badge of honor that I only slept 2 hours last night. Oh, well, you're an idiot then. Like, what's the point of feeling all right if all you're going to do is beat yourself up every single day? Yeah. And I think that's one thing is like, one thing I would love to have change is if you could tell somebody, when we have clients come in, one of the first things we tell them to do is like have a more intimate relationship with your mattress. And that sounds kind of bad offhand, but it's just to regain the familiarity of knowing what it's like to get a good night's sleep, because, hell, most people don't. I mean, I know we just went through that in our house, with our daughter. I know David, with his son, going through all that and really trying to understand what it's like to get back into sleeping. Derek's got kids all over, so he knows. Like I said, silent, but strong. I think the sleep one is huge, and definitely moving. I really wanted to steal both of those and just combine them into mine, but I'll go to sleep as well. Like I said, that's the biggest thing, because how it can affect you hormonally, and all this work you might put into changing your diet and working out and all that great stuff doesn't mean crap if you don't have that chance to recover and regenerate. Are those the right words?
Yeah, sleep is this is a simple one to do. Simple in theory and everything, too, but we do have to make it, for sure, an effort, especially people that aren't used to it. But, man, when you make that change, or whenever you were going sleep-deprived for so long and you start gaining more sleep back, you realize how much you missed it and how much you do need it and how much that makes you feel better. And that's the only change you had to make, and it can make a huge impact.
You would be able to tell us about that, huh?
Yeah. We saw how cranky David got when he did not get his sleep. It was bad.
I lost like 10 pounds just from every pound that my son gained, I lost. So it did not work out very well for me. I was not trying to lose weight, okay? Some people might be, but no, I was not. I was trying to, if anything, gain weight. And so I was going the opposite direction with the little sleep I was getting. Felt like I was lost.
Yeah, it's sleep's a big deal. And so, yeah, don't really just set it out and be like, oh, I got to work out. Let me add a day of workouts. No, screw that. When it's like, oh, I got to change all this food. No, screw that. Just get some sleep. Make that your priority and then move from there. And so since that's kind of like the general tip that we'll throw out, it's all right, how do you get that sleep? I mean, that's kind of the next transition, I think, here is how do you get to sleep and, have a restful night's worth of sleep. Get your 8 hours, whatever it is. Blue lights, all that good stuff. Thoughts?
Yeah, I definitely think making your room so much a little cooler when you're about to go to sleep, making sure all your electronics are out of the way, TV's off, if you even have one in the room, and making sure just everything's comfortable for you when you're about to get ready to go to bed.
Yeah, you want to have like a wind-down process. Maybe you can spend the last 30 minutes. You could do it foam rolling. You could do it just relaxing, reading a book. But getting away from those screens, get your phone away, get that out of the room even. What else? Even a white noise machine. Well, I never had one before, but man, when I had our son and he had one on his little swing thing, and then when he left, I was like, man, I missed that. So I think we're probably going to be getting one for our room too. If the fan's not running, then yeah, a white noise machine might be a good option to have, just to drown out any sort of outside noise or distractions that could interrupt you while you're going to sleep.
Yeah, that was one thing I thought was really weird with my wife. I hope she probably won't listen to this, so I'll say that. But when we first got married, she had this white noise machine, and I didn't understand it, and it was kind of odd to me, but like trying to go to sleep with noise, it didn't make a lot of sense until I realized like I didn't hear all the crap that was outside, cars going by, people screaming. We live in apartments, so it was loud. The toddler upstairs played drums like all day, so it drowned all that out. And so that was helpful. And yeah, especially like I've noticed with my daughter, we put one in her room, and as soon as her wind down, we put her in there, we turn on the noisemaker, and you can just see she looks over at us. She's like, "It's time to get to business. I'm going to sleep." So it helps drown out all that excess noise. Derek talked about keeping the room cool, like temperature wise. What do you guys set your rooms to, or thermostats, I should say?
We put it at 68.
68, that's not, I think it's where we're 67 is our new low.
Right. Yeah, we're at 70 during the summer just because we're a little cheap. But during the winter, man, I mean, we keep it at like 65. We're not putting the heat on for anything, so it'll definitely sleep better during the winter. But man, this summer has been brutal.
Yeah, it's been pretty rough down here. But nothing beats like a pair of cold sheets. Yeah. I mean, like, you slip into that, you hit, like, as cool as the other side of the pillow, Stuart Scott statement, you hit that, and the sheets are cool, and you got your noisemaker on, you don't have your TV on, because you could probably miss that episode of whatever junk TV would be on anyways at night, and really, yeah, just winding down, most of us, we still have our laptops or our phones. I know I'll check to see what pointless stuff is on Facebook at those times, and, you know, just really waste time anyways. I could put that into a recovery and regeneration aspect and get sleep. So yeah, check that out. Turn down the thermostats. Make it a little bit cooler in your house. Turn on the noisemakers. Just get a TV out of your room. Unless, yeah, like, you have to have it in. Oh, well, I don't even know why you'd have to have it in there. I don't know. You have a TV in your room?
We actually do have a TV in our room, but it has not been turned on since actually we've moved in there. So I don't know what the purpose of the TV just mounted in our wall. I guess it's all about looks, but
feng shui.
Yeah. I don't even know if it's actually plugged in.
We do not have a TV. We only have one TV, so it's definitely not in our room.
We have 8 TVs in our house.
That's a lot of TVs.
We don't have 8 TVs. I should just have one big TV. No, we have two maybe, but one's not plugged in. No TV. I've never had a TV in my room until I went to college, and then I just know that I would stay up all night watching whatever movies were on or the same TV show over and over and over. So I didn't sleep, obviously, in college.
It's definitely a big distraction, or tempting if you do have it.
Yeah. I mean, distractions. That's another one we could touch on since we're winging this right now. But I think distractions are big. You talk about starting a program and really getting into, you don't even call it a program, whether it's a regimen, routine, anything like that, distracted. I'm like the most easily distracted person I know. It's kind of one of those things you walk around, you're like, oh, hey, someone's out there, I'm gonna go talk to them. And then you turn back around, you're like, I forgot what I was gonna say because somebody walked, I don't know, anything. But distractions and how you can minimize those with workouts. Any ideas? That was a long-winded question.
I mean, for me, just, I guess if I'm working out just to stay concentrated, I like to have my own headphones, you know, plugged in, cut all the noise from outside and just concentrate on whatever workout I'm doing and kill everything else, just the music, and get going.
Fine, getting someone to work out with that always helps hold you a little bit accountable, a little bit more focused. Definitely find out when I'm by myself, I kind of wing it. I don't always make it the full, even 30 minutes that I'm aiming for. So, but yeah, if you get a partner, then it's much easier to kind of help push each other. Alternate picking out exercises just between the two of you can help, definitely help the workout and the flow and everything.
Yeah, that makes a big difference. Yeah, the accountability aspect of it's huge. Because if you have someone you know that you're like, all right, we're going to meet at this time, do this workout, great. I know I work better like that. Otherwise, I give myself an out. I'm like, oh, it's 11 o'clock and not 10:45. I guess I should not work out and find those reasons. Just because I typically hate to work out. It sounds weird. That's my confession for the day. But it just at times seems monotonous and pointless. And I'm sure some people who would listen to this would relate to that. And that's my excuse. And so I have to do something that's fun. Like we went paddleboarding in Austin. To me, that's more enjoyable to do. It's movement-based, like David mentioned earlier. So it's still something. And so for peace of mind, like that stuff I relate better to than going in and busting out, you know, however many sets and reps. But I think having a workout partner is huge for me. Although, like I said, distraction-wise, it just gives me someone to talk to the entire time. I'm sure Derek, that's probably why Derek puts on headphones if we work out, so you don't have to listen to me talk. But I think, yeah, the distraction aspect of it is huge. So if you have somebody that you can work out with, go find them. And then if not, meet somebody at a gym or enlist somebody or just
make sure they're not wearing the headphones because that means they do not want you to come and talk to them.
Yeah, don't search out the person with the headphones because, yeah, they're on for, even if they're not listening to anything, they just don't want to talk to you. So avoid that at all costs because you might look stupid. I don't know. That's a good point that you brought up there. So, yeah, if you take anything away from this today, just don't talk to the people with headphones because you're just making them mad and frustrating them. All right, so we've touched on getting good sleep and just getting out and moving, distractions, and then any other things you guys can think of, like for somebody just starting.
I mean, beside all those basic ones, I just think sleep, having fun with it, cutting out distractions, and I would say eating. I mean, make sure you're eating good stuff, along with other stuff, and I think that pretty much covers all the basics.
I think we have one more thing we missed out on the sleeping part is the caffeine. Try not to have anything, you know, probably 8 to 10 hours before you go down. I mean, really, it's that afternoon coffee that you drink, you think it's helping you out through the afternoon, but really it's hurting your sleep. You're like, oh man, I can go to sleep. I can drink coffee and then go to sleep in 2 hours. You think it is, but then you wake up throughout the day, you're just, or that sleep, and you're disrupted. So really, that caffeine matters. So try to avoid that afternoon coffee. And really, that kind of goes back to that, your afternoons might be crashing because of what you're eating. But we'll delve into that a little bit later.
No, that's definitely a good point. Everybody handles caffeine a little bit differently. And, you know, you might think you're fine, but like David said, you probably aren't regardless. So just avoid that 3 o'clock coffee. And just
5-hour energies for sure.
Yeah.
Should I not take my pre-workout after 4 o'clock?
Now? Pre-workout. Pre-workout. You always see those pictures on those videos on Facebook. Like,
I would take one scoop.
Well, one scoop. If it's a rounded scoop.
Is it blue?
Yeah.
Is it blue?
We know what David's like on pre-workout.
That's bad.
He gets jacked.
You just don't keep away the blue stuff.
Bench is like 700 pounds.
Mm-hmm. Probably the only benefit, but maybe. It's crash and burn later.
Yeah, it's a terrible feeling.
That's a lot of caffeine right there.
Yeah. Well, how about this? We'll throw out stimulants in general. Meth. Is typically one to avoid past a certain time.
Speed,
yeah. 8-balls, also bad. Caffeine, pre-workout, all these things that a lot of us will take for that stimulated, obviously, effect. Don't do that before you go to bed. Or even, like I said, David said, 8 to 10 hours before. It seems like a long time, but that's kind of the reality of it. Coffee should not be a crutch. It should just be something you enjoy doing. I think those are some good tips, avoiding that stuff. Let's see who's going to walk in here. Look like a child. Sounded weird. all right, so I think, those are some good simple steps to get started and just making sure you do things. And I think that statement itself is keep it simple. That whole KISS principle is don't overthink it. Don't be like, all right, you know, they said to move. I should go do 15 sprints. No. It's just move. Have fun. With exercise, you know, don't try and jump into like a clean and jerk on day one. Just, why don't you just do a squat and start there?
Do what feels good.
Yeah. I mean, you got it. Now, to that note, don't use that excuse and say, well, I'm sore. It doesn't feel good. I shouldn't do it. Just play it slow. Keep it simple. Don't go crazy. Don't go buy like the huge jar of pre-workout and all that junk before you get started because you want to get super ripped. Just get started. That's the biggest thing.
Gains come slow,
yeah. Everyone thinks that you can just get super jacked, you know, the six-pack abs, that you should look like the supermodel that you saw on TV or, you know, a number of things. It doesn't work like that at all. So know it's going to take time. Keep it simple. And I think, yeah, those are some, you know, the next thing we're talking about, like problems and mistakes people make is not keeping it simple, obviously, but then thinking that it's going to happen overnight. You're going to have this overnight success. You do, you know, one good tricep workout. You think like your guns are going to look really, really great from there on. It doesn't work like that. David's checking his guns out, trying to keep people, the visual aspect going here.
Of the real games.
Yeah.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's a big mistake. And then, you know, comparing yourself to an image or an idea, I think, is another big thing. Is you are different than every single person that is out there. That's why you are you, not them. So don't look at them and say, well, they're doing this, I should be doing this. You know, things like that. I know with workout partners, you know, that can happen. But Derek benches a lot more than me. I'm fine with that because I can scratch the middle of my back, and I know he can't. Talk about mobility. But
yeah, it's not the best, but it's all right. You said I do bench more than David.
Yeah. He wants to focus on the positives. But I think, yeah, problems and mistakes, you know, those are something to really think about. And like I said, mine is don't compare yourself, and, you know, Derek said, obviously, realize it's going to take time. David, thoughts?
I mean, really people think that you have to do a lot to be healthy. Really, you just have to make a few steps, do them consistently to get healthy. It's when people get extreme that they're looking for those last few end results, and that's when you have to really, you know, change what you're doing. But starting off, it's just a few changes that you have to really make. Be dedicated, consistent on it.
Dedication and patience.
Yeah, that's one thing most of us don't have, either of them, dedication and patience. All right. So that's kind of it. That's our introduction. We'll get better on this stuff, I know, especially as we get kind of more ideas and really start working through all of these different podcasts, knowing that we are doing our best to help you guys see the gains in every way of life possible while enjoying a nice thing of peanut butter or however you want to do it. But I had this quote I wanted to throw out there. I had to send it to my brother yesterday, if I can find it. All right, and it's from Albert Einstein. He was a pretty smart guy, so I figured it was a safe way to go. But it is a ship is always safe at the shore, but that is not what it's built for. That's kind of like my motivational cue for everybody to kind of think and leave on, but it's pretty powerful. I think that most of us get stuck in this comfort zone. So if you're starting a fitness program or a routine or whatever it is, it's not a comfortable place to be. So go out there, try something new, and watch as your life kind of unfolds into something better than what you thought possible from it. And so don't just do something because that's what you've always done. Be open-minded. Any thoughts on that, guys?
I mean, just get your PB&Gains. That's all I gotta say.
Try some new stuff.
Yeah, try some new stuff. Don't be boring. All right, so thank you guys for joining us. We will have another one coming out, date TBD. I said we're still working on the kinks of this bad boy. So thank you guys for listening. We really appreciate it. I said avenuefit.com. I will put some other stuff in the show notes if you want to get in touch with either of us about any questions you might have or you have ideas for the show. And then let us know what you think of it. You know, feel free. We'll post this wherever we possibly can. So love to hear feedback from you guys. That's all I have to say. So peace out. Enjoy the day.
Were we actually recording?